come to Albert Square, I've done nothing but meet new relations. Really close ones that I never even knew I had. You're my first cousin, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I like it here, though.
So why'd you leave home?
Everyone asked me that.
Everyone asked me that?
Yeah, well, for me, it was a case of having to. You see, I got into some financial difficulties.
And get them sorted?
Oh, yeah.
So why don't you go back?
Well, go back to me mum. Now, there comes a time, don't there?
Too true, mate.
Yeah.
But unlike me, you seem to have got away with it.
How do you mean?
Well, you leave home and you're Mr. Golden Boy. I leave home and I'm a big problem. Black sheep of the family. I mean, why?
Well, it's all a case of presentation, isn't it? It's how you make it seem. See, with mothers, you just got to keep them sweet. Do what you like, go where you like, but always say goodbye. And always give them an address. It needn't be where you're actually going, but it makes them feel loved and wanted, then.
Has anyone seen Sharon?
She's at school.
Ben's only gone and cancelled the flipping Kissagram advert. We have to put it in again with my number now.
Sausage, egg and
chips
twice and two slices of bread,
yeah?
Come out, one minute,
what's that? Here, you're busy, mate. What have you done with the ladies?
Had them for breakfast, on toast.
Something wrong with hands, though, are you?
Yeah, so you aren't in Catholic, eh? But I don't know, it's the nerves.
Yeah, well, I'm not too much well up on now, with gossip, am I?
Yeah, here, Mark, have a sit down.
Well, how long since I last see you, eh, mate? About a year. So what's it like out there, eh, in the big wide world?
Much the same as it is here, really.
Yeah, well, you're living with the older woman, oh.
Sorry, Uncle B, but I don't really want to talk about it.
Okay, mate, okay, keep your head on. Yeah, you still got that job, have you? What is it, working in the fairground?
Amusement park,
yeah. Yeah, great, great. So what's your plans for long-term future, eh?
Well, I'm thinking of having dinner over at Graham's, but I ain't sussed out to you.
All right, Mark, I'll get the message. You don't want to talk to me, that's no problem. If I tell you something, sonny, I hope in future you show your mother more consideration.
Yeah, thanks for the drink. Woody's on to me like I've never left. Got to show you more consideration, apparently. Tell you my plans and that.
I never said that, Mark.
No, but Uncle Pete did, and Wixie and Gren. So I will.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
Mum, my plans are. Well, I've left Southend for a start.
What, for good?
Yeah, it looks like it.
What about Ingrid?
Well, we split up.
Oh, Mark.
It's all right. She kicked me out. Said I was too young for her.
Oh, Mark, I am sorry.
I'll get over it.
Yeah. Well, listen, don't worry. We'll get the bedroom sorted out and we
Mum.
Can...
Mum?
Look, what I mean is you can't have your old room
I'm
back
not
because...
I'm not stopping.
What?
Just because I've left Southend, it don't mean I'm coming back here, does it?
Oh. Well, what are you going to do then?
I don't know. Go off somewhere else, I suppose.
Well, that's daft. I mean, I'd like you here with me for a bit.
But it wouldn't work.
Why not? Works for Ian and it works for Kelvin. Why can't it work for you?
I don't know.
Well, where are you going to go?
I don't know yet.
Well, when?
This afternoon sometime.
This afternoon? You've only just got here.
So what's all this in aid of
you? I just wanted the chance to see you before I left, that's all. It's impossible to try and talk at home.
Oh, I know what you mean. I don't really know what to say to you anymore, Mark. You feel like a stranger now.
How do you think I feel?
So what are you going to do next?
Well, I don't know.
I mean, like, where are you going tonight?
Oh, I'll get that sorted out later. I've got to go and see this mate.
Where's that?
I don't know yet. Somewhere. Eat your bun.
Then you got one.
Yeah, but I ain't eating for two, am I? Good luck with the baby and everything, shall we?
Thanks, Mark.
When you having?
End of May now.
Yeah? How do you feel? You scared?
Oh, not scared. Numb, I suppose. Sometimes I don't think it's happening to me. I feel like I'm going to wake up and find it was all a dream. Or a nightmare.
Well, it looks pretty real to me. Look, I'll tell you one thing, though. I bet it's a girl.
Yeah?
I got psychic powers, didn't you know? But they ain't telling me who the dad is, though. I sort of like to know. But I ain't gonna tell anyone. I ain't even around anymore.
Just leave it, Mark, please. Would you like...
You awake? You awake?
I'll let you know in a minute.
I ain't much in the way of hills and valleys round here.
More of a slag heap, really.
Well, do you mind? I was born here.
So?
So it's a slag heap.
And now you're back.
Yeah, because I promised. Then we can take to the hills again.
A farmer promised us some more work. Andy let us sleep in his barn.
Yeah, and he brews his own beer.
Andy's got a whole empty field.
So?
So we could grow things.
What, leeks? Well, I've never had beer for breakfast before.
Well, if we go back, you'd be having it every day.
Would you fancy a pint now?
No, not really. Fancy a cup of tea, though.
It's too early yet. Look, Owen, yeah. While we're here, try not to act like a Martian, all right?
Beat me up, Scotty.
My mum and dad have got this allergy against loonies.
Look, everyone else is a loony. I'm the only sane one.
You'll just pretend it's the other way around, all right?
Best behaviour, Captain Kirk.
You got any uncles?
All valley folk.
Well, I'm an uncle.
That's what you said.
Well, are you going to see me acting like an uncle? So if I do anything strange, and that's because I'm acting like an uncle, right?
That's Mark! Arthur, it's Mark!
Mark?
Mark,
oh, you little perisher, you didn't give us any warning. Right, yeah, nice to see you, son. Lovely, yes. And who's this then, Mark?
Oh, that's Owen from Wales.
Owen from Wales, eh?
Shemai.
Shemai.
We could have a lot of fun guessing who your dad is, couldn't we?
Just think you was that age once, Dad.
Yeah.
So was I when you helped me.
Funny old world, isn't it?
Didn't I see you on Mastermind?
So what sort of uncle do you want me to be then, Shell?
Yeah. Don't make out it don't mean anything.
Well, she's got an uncle who keeps his promises.
Well, that's good enough.
Yeah, and I'd like a son who keeps his promises.
Either I've trod in something, or that baby needs changing.
I've just changed her.
And I ain't been out yet.
Some people say I smell of the country.
Which country?
I was born in a cow shed.
I should, yeah. That reminds me, I must mulch me marrow.
I had a friend once, had a marrow.
Well, is that episode one or is that it? I mean, was it your marrow or your friend?
Big green one it was, with a hint of scarlet. Beautiful it was, reminded me of William Blake. A man could see the universe in a marrow.
That kid's got some sense. Would you like to see mine, then?
Like an unexploded bomb it was, sticking out of the ground.
Oh, I have that in this dream. Yeah, they're all advancing on the marrow with their rifles, ready to shoot it up. And in this dream, they riddle it with bullets, carving their name on the marrow. And that's what I dreamt.
Dreams mean things. You are the marrow. The marrow is you. There's this tribe of ancient Indians who worship the marrow. It's a great symbol of fertility, the marrow. In fact, I often think that Pink Floyd's Animals, their classic album, should have been called Marrows. And the cover, you know, should have been Marrows floating above Battersea Power Station. It's just as valid.
Who is this Pink Lloyd? Where's his allotment then?
What's that with you?
I don't know, it's the aroma. I'm getting eye on it. It's like conversing with a cow.
He is a bit sleazy, isn't he?
Sleazy, sleazy rider, that's who it is.
Sleazy rider?
Yeah, they came in on a motorbike, didn't they? I'll tell you what, son, you may pen and ink a bit, but I'm enjoying myself. Now tell me, how do you earn a living?
This and that.
Has it got anything to do with pigs? This and that?
Well, we have done a bit of agricultural work, yeah.
Yeah, but nothing specifically to do with pigs.
course.
I'll come with you.
No, you won't.
What do you mean, no, you won't? It's me you're talking to.
Why don't you ask her for a date?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Go on, Dad, show us how it's done.
I'm not going to date your mother for your course amusement. Now, come on, Pauline, let's come.
Sorry, Arthur, no. If you want to book me for another night, then that's fine. Tomorrow, yes, tonight, no.
Well, tomorrow night, no, Wednesday, that's my Mara lecture. Now, how about Thursday?
Okay, yes. I mean, I quite understand. My creative expression class is your marrow. Fine. Thursday it is. If he can't give me more notice, I have to get on with my life just the same.
You know, I sometimes feel like Custer's last stand. Standing there alone with me marrow in me hand. Or the geezer on the burning deck.
The tolling of the iron bell.
Tolls the death of little Nell. That's it, I'm off.
Where are you going?
I've got a business appointment.
Baby.
Let Uncle in there look after his brother for a couple of hours. You know, this creative expression is a double-edged sword. Mm. Yeah, it cuts both ways. Ta-da, fellas.
Bye, boys. See you later.
Sane enough for you? I told you everyone else was mad. They're nutters, man.
Are you like, sir?
Well, why not? I'm likeable.
You can make some good science fiction films with marrows in, couldn't you? Like, you could have Night of the Living Marrow.
War on Marrows.
Destination Marrow.
Marrow from outer space.
French Lieutenant's Marrow.
I married a Marrow.
Would you mind?
Look, I'm going to go up and see Michelle for a minute.
No, no, you won't.
Why?
She's got a visitor.
Oh, I see. Abbott and Costello meet the Marrow.
No, no, this is it. I've got it. Look. Marrow 4, in which Sylvester Stallone fights a giant Marrow from outer space and loses, thus paving the way for Marrow 5, where he fights a giant Russian Marrow from outer space.
Intergalactic ballistic Marrow.
The true threat to mankind.
Marrow sandwiches. Now then, Leo, do you want to sleep indoors tonight?
It's all the same to me. Well, to be honest, I think I prefer the great outdoors.
There's no great outdoors round here. No,
there's the marshes. Don't go over the marshes.
Arthur.
Yes, right. You know, this isn't a safari park. This is your home, Albert Square.
Oh, I don't want to sleep here.
All right, I'll put up a notice. Mark Fowler never slept here.
But you can't sleep outside. I mean, you get trod on. There's dogs and muggers.
Marrows.
And the law. Suppose you get nicked for being a vagrant outside your own house. Terrific. Vicky's uncle's a vagrant already.
Well, we can stay at Lofty's Inn. I mean, he's nearly my brother-in-law. Aren't you, Lofty?
You were,
And I is quite fond of you already.
Well, hygienic-wise, that suits me.
What kind of house you got, Lofty?
Same as this, only dirtier.
How do you mean, exactly?
Well, I was just wondering, could we bring our bike in with us?
Hello, fellas.
Hello.
Hi, hi. What happened? The big collapse?
Very funny.
Well, you got my aftershave on.
It's not yours, it's mine. Mum gave it to me for Christmas.
I don't remember that.
It's your age.
Oh, now, don't push it, son. Hey, did you say good morning to your mum?
Yeah, after breakfast, though.
Yeah, first things first. Didn't Lofty get you any grub?
We had that last night.
Spicy, was it? Oh, struth.
Cup of tea?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I'll have an egg roll, thanks, Dad.
Right, come over and get it when it's ready.
Yeah, this job's not regular, then.
It ain't even temporary.
So, in that case, would you like to look out the stall while we're on holiday?
Not much, I wouldn't.
Right, you're on, mate.
Great, great.
See you,
I like that.
What?
I just had my holiday money cut off.
No, I'm afraid we have no vehicles available. Well, I said, didn't I? What? Oh, you dirty... Disgusting. Well, I'm not standing for that. Not in my state, Elf.
What's up, Doc?
Look, I don't mind doing Sue and Nanny a favour, but I draw the line at pervert.
What did he say?
Wasn't he? It was a she. And I'm not repeating it.
And what about our two, Arthur?
Yeah, come on, Uncle, I'll get a move on.
Oh, lousy service in here.
Hey,
Bill. Yeah, tip for me, Arthur.
Okay,
mate. Hey, hi, guys. Let's talk music, because I've got some really great ideas.
Oh, sorry, Dad. We're not very chatty this morning.
Oh?
Oh, this is Owen, Mark's mate. Have you met him?
So you're into music, yeah?
Yeah, we're just starting to get an act together. Hope to get our first gig in a month or so.
If we stay together that long.
Well, who's leaving?
Well, you, for one. Technology killed the drummer. You're going to be redundant.
Yeah, well, so will Harry be if he tries that.
What kind of song do you make?
Well, it's more of a row at the moment. A cross between Paul Weller, Aha, and Dennis Roussos.
Oh, come on, take it seriously, will you?
I'm the only one who does.
What sort of music are you into then, Owen?
Pink Floyd.
Oh, yeah, you said.
Do you like them?
Yeah, of course we do, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
You haven't even heard of them, have you? And you say you like music. If you haven't heard the Floyd,
You haven't heard nothing.
Look, you two have got to make up your minds about what you want to be. If it's politicians, then join a party. If you want to make music, join a band. It's as simple as that. Look, you can't wave a red flag and play the drums at the same time.
Yeah, you're right there.
You'll end up as corrupt as the system you're knocking, you see.
Well, that's really cynical.
Look, there's only one thing you can change in this world, and that's yourself.
Yeah, what do you want to make political statements for, anyway?
Well, it's through art that people can influence their struggle.
What struggle?
For freedom.
Look, Pink Floyd did more to influence US troops in Vietnam than any political trash. And why? Because the music is the message, that's why. Look, forget all that Marxist graffiti and follow the Floyd. Punk's dead, politics stink. But the Floyd goes on forever.
Ian, not a dog.
Hey, that sounds like a 50s number.
Yeah, ain't nothing but a hound dog. Ruh, something.
We've got to enter the ashtray. I want a word with you. Now. Look, you stupid fool. You want to wreck your life on this filth? Go ahead. But you're not going to drag my kids with you. You understand that? Now get on that bike of yours and head right back to the valleys, or so help me. I'll stuff the contents of every ashtray in this pub right down your throat. Now shift it.
I've been around.
Yeah, all right.
But that is primitive.
Well, that's lofty.
And he's marrying your sister?
Yeah.
Well, I'd be suspicious of anybody who didn't have a drop of milk for his tea in the morning.
Just gotta be careful and get a cup over there.
Yeah, still here.
Looks like it.
I'd get on that bike of yours and move now.
She the local sheriff, are you?
I'm just telling you.
Nothing changes around here, does it?
Just go before I make you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Come on, Markman. Let's do as the man asks.
Hey?
This square ain't big enough for the three of us.
The drawer's cut it.
Okay. Coming up.
Hello, what's Cabs?
Tea, is it?
Yeah, please.
What's the matter? Your mum's tea no good.
Well, we're not staying at my mum's, we're over at Lofty's.
And he's got no milk.
Well, yeah, it's pretty solid.
Don't look now, Miami Vice is back.
I thought we decided you two were leaving.
What is this?
Mark has to say his goodbyes, doesn't he? We'll be gone by tonight, all right?
Just make sure you are.
What's this all about then?
Ask them.
Hello, what's going
on? Oh, Yates the Welsh.
Why?
Don't know. I think it's got something to do with the type of grass we grow there.
Stop it. Hello, sir. All right. Right. We don't have to send you an invitation, do we?
Aye.
To Shell's wedding.
He had no milk this morning.
Who didn't?
Lofty. I found that very suspect myself.
What's he talking about?
Milk.
I think your friend's brain's addled.
And listen, your brain would be more than addled if you don't start wearing a crash helmet.
Yeah, I just came to say we'll be off tonight.
Well, where are you going?
Back to Wales.
Yeah, I think you ought to stop a little bit longer for your mum's sake.
No, we can't.
Why not?
Reasons.
Reasons to be cheerful. Part three.
What?
It's a song.
Is it indeed?
I've been to the laundrette and seen Mum.
Well, when are you off then?
Dunno, about 8. I'll see you before I go, all right?
Yeah, all right, ta-da. But at least he's not sneaking off this time and Pauline will be able to say goodbye properly.
Yeah. Here.
Oh.
Do you think we could get away with £2.10, Ed?
Yeah, well, it's just the way he just didn't leave this morning. All we've done is hang around all day.
It's a matter of principle.
Oh. So where's your next stop?
Back to Wales, I suppose.
No, I've got to do something first. Don't know, can't remember.
Yeah, how much of that stuff do you smoke? So even I can tell it's too much. You'll end up like him. Right, where is she?
Mrs. Anonymous, what's her name?
She's
in bed.
What's that?
She's at it again, that's what. Right, what's this about? I thought you'd have learnt your lesson by now.
What are you talking about?
The anonymous letter. I would pay up now if I were you to avoid them suing you. Do you think I'm an idiot?
You saying that I sent that?
I know you sent it. You wanted to see me go under ever since I moved in here. You shout, love thy neighbour in one voice and send them all back in another.
I don't.
Do you think? You make me sick, you know that?
Lama.
You're an evil person. You're not going to get the better of me. Come on. It's all right.
No, it's not.
What's that all about?
I don't know.
She's just under a lot of pressure at the moment with a new shop and everything.
But why me? I never sent no letter.
Just forget it. Don't let it worry you.
Oh, I know. It's just...
What?
Oh, everything's just...
Go on.
To get me down.
What's that letter?
You need cheering up, lady.
Oh, my God, what's that?
It's all right, it's only Owen. Look, I'll be back in a second.
Only Owen. You nearly scared me to death.
I never get down.
Don't you?
No. Every time I feel like it's getting heavy, then...
What's just getting heavy?
Life.
Oh.
Did I just have a cigarette? And it all disappears.
Well, should never get heavy for me, then. I smoke more than I breathe.
Yeah, but you got the wrong brand.
Have I?
Yeah, you need a different brand.
Owen, Mark, will you come and sort out your real Billy friends or something? He wants to give Dot a new brand of cigarette.
There's nothing wrong with that,
you're serving. Well, he just had it
out. Yeah, but heavy can mean bad, or heavy can mean good, depending on which way you look at it, see?
Oh. And this man knows.
Yeah, try this, then you know what I mean.
Dot.
Oh, that's all right, Michelle. I smoke so much, another brand won't make no difference.
No, it's not a cigarette, Doc.
Still saying your goodbyes?
She's got...
I thought you two were leaving.
But we go when we're ready.
Which is now.
You really think you're the man, don't you?
I know when something stinks in more ways than one.
Hey, what's this all about?
Drugs.
Right? He was around my place smoking dope.
Who was?
He was.
My son was there too.
Ian?
Yes.
Ian was.
Look, man, are you maybe just a little bit jealous, is that it? You want to try some?
You are!
Oh, yeah.
Well, if I should do it outside in the square, not in here, all right?
Look, we just wanted a drink for the road. I didn't realise this guy owned the pub as well as the square.
He doesn't. You want a drink? Have one. I've no argument with you.
They're pushing drugs.
You say so. I don't know that.
Oh, it doesn't matter. We're not thirsty anymore, are we, Mark?
Aren't we?
Besides, these are the pubs. Come on.
You can't go around accusing people, Tony. You've got to have proof.
We've got proof.
Not going to tell Ian, you haven't?
Well, he was there.
Well, that don't mean to say he's guilty.
Look, we're just trying to warn you, that's all.
Funny way of going about it, isn't it, Tony? Shouting your mouth off.
All right, let's just calm it down, shall we? Just calm it down.
I'm trying to get back to the wedding.
Oh, don't worry about it. You come to see Vicky, it means a lot to me, thanks.
See you then,
Mark. Bye, Mark. Take care of yourself, Ian. You will let us know where you are, won't you?
Of course.
Remember what I've got to do. I'll pick you up tomorrow, okay?
That's my creative expression, girl.
Where did you get to last night?
Short Farmway, bit of business.
You already had your breakfast?
Yeah, why?
Just feeling generous, just going off to pay.
Did you come in with some money for this business, eh?
Sold a bit of gear, didn't I?
You want to be careful.
What for? There's too much of it going on up here for the law to keep an eye on. It's a doddle, man. It's one of the reasons I came with you in the first place.
Yeah, well, you want to watch it anyway.
You wait for you, Mark.
What's up, Uncle Pete?
What's up? What's up? Your mate, that's what's up. Do Lally, ain't he? You been giving marijuana to young Cassie?
No.
Well, she says different. If it wasn't for you, I'd smash one of those bloody stalls over your head, son. And when her father catches up with you, he's gonna get the biggest hiding of your life, Sophie.
To get on your bike now. And you too, Mark. But go on, before you go, don't say goodbye to your mother. I'll make an excuse for you.
Mark? There you are, then. She's all yours.
Mark! Mark, you coming home tonight?
Sorry, love. How are you?
What?
You lost weight?
Anybody would in this place.
tough, is it?
Okay.
Here. I wanted to bring you 60, but it cost more to get here than I thought.
So what am I here now, 20? What's not the rest of you?
Oh. Gran and Shell send their love. Vicky's coming on a treat. When you get out, you'll have to come and see her.
About Dad?
Oh, he's all right.
What's he said?
Oh, well, you know him. Not much.
Thought you might have come with you.
He couldn't, Mark. He was busy. Well, treating you all right, are they?
It's not hospital, Mum. I'm supposed to come out of here a changed person, fit to rejoin society.
Yeah.
It's not a cushy number.
No. Well, how do you feel?
About?
Well, about what you did.
And what?
But have you changed?
Yeah, I've changed.
Well, how?
Sam.
Oh, Mark, you didn't...
No, I didn't pay protection.
Eh?
This kid, it doesn't matter.
No, tell me, what happened?
Well, this kid's wanted half my fair grace, and I wouldn't give it to him, so he slipped my wrist. I think with another couple of daddies.
Oh, gosh. But what did you do?
I gave him the fags.
Did you report him?
Risk it in the other one, Slip.
God, it's not right.
It's the way it is, one. I just didn't learn quick enough. It's all right now, they know I'm not here.
When you come out of here, I think you ought to come home and stay with us for a while.
I'll see.
You can have Shell's old room.
Oh, that's right. When did it at last, didn't she?
Promised me.
I can't promise you, mate. I'll see how I feel.
You shouldn't be in here.
Short, sharp shock. That's what they used to call these places, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's about right as well.
But has it put you off doing it again?
No, I don't think so. Just make sure I don't get caught next time. Best thing about this place, you know. Give you so much exercise, by the time I get out, I'll be so fit they won't be able to catch me.
Mark, you shouldn't do it. You mustn't do things like that.
Leave it out, Mum. I've had that ram down my throat since I got here.
Oh, Mark, I don't understand you.
It's not that hard, really. I was bright, so I thought I'd help myself.
But we brought you up right. We brought you up not to do things
you
like that.
You brought me up in the East End, Mum. The only honest person I knew was my old man. I don't have to pretend anymore. I know where he is. He's in the funny farm. So if that's where an honest life gets you, then forget it.
How did you find out?
There was a kid who nearly lived down Turpin Road, knocked about him when I was at school. Came on a bit strong about it one day.
Mark,
I broke his nose and a couple of fingers.
I blame people like him.
Why?
Because if you hadn't knocked about with people like him, I don't reckon you'd be in here now.
I should believe it, Mum.
Okay. I've been talking to that Colin. You know, I reckon he's had a raw deal, that one. I mean, stop, people like her, they just don't know what they're talking about. Do you know what she says? She says all this comes from... Oh, Mark.
Hello, Mum.
Oh, you're back.
Lucette, why are you here?
Oh, why didn't you tell us you were coming?
Didn't think.
Did you know?
He just turned up on my doorstep.
None like. Of us knew Pauline.
Oh, how long are you staying?
I don't know yet.
You can have Shell's old room.
Well,
look, you're staying and that's the end of it. We need a man about the house, your gran and me.
Oh, yes, your mum's right, son.
Dad, no, I'm here.
No, he's not, but soon.
I thought I might...
Look, you can stop thinking. You're staying and that's the end of it. I've got to tidy Shell's room now before I go back to work. Hey, I won't be a minute.
Looks like you got no choice, didn't it?
Doc, look, I know what you think, but I need to talk to you just to explain things to you. Please open up, Doc. I don't believe this.
Blossom, hello, Colin.
Hello, Colin.
Now, don't you want that service washed?
Well, yeah, I did really, but, you know.
What, no Doc skived off early, has she?
No, not exactly.
Leave it, I'll do it. Collect it later.
Oh, thanks, Paul. Right. There's the money.
It's Barry's birthday today, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. They have a lunchtime drink. Celebrate. Come over if you want.
Well, it's a bit awkward with Vicky, you know.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll leave it up to you. See you.
See ya.
He's new around here, isn't he?
Yeah, he lives at Tony's. He bought one of the flats there.
Looks like.
He designs things.
Ian, language.
What's his name?
That's... Agent of the devil.
Dot.
Yeah, I'll
do that. Hold on a mo. I'm just coming out.
What are you doing in there, Dot?
Hiding from him.
Who?
That Colin.
Don't you think you're taking this too far?
I don't want to catch what he's got.
He hasn't got anything.
How do you know?
Because he told me.
He hath brought forth falsehood.
It's
What are you babbling on about now, you daft bat?
I know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about retribution. And Pauline Fowler, after handing them clothes, I'd go straight home and bath in disinfectant.
Thought about getting a job or anything?
No. Oh, Shara's one to ask about that. She changes her job like some people change their underwear.
Oh, where is she now?
Oh, she's got a good job in the travel agents.
Yeah, she's on one of them YTS training things, whatever they're called. I don't know.
Good for her.
Yes, but Mark, have you thought what you're gonna do?
No.
Was it hard in there?
Yeah, it was hard. But I know it now. Once you know it, it's never that bad.
What's that mean?
I learnt a lot in there, Gren. I learnt a lot.
Like what, love?
Well, how to pass the blame, how not to trust anybody, how to keep your mouth shut, and how to smile at people you hate.
I meant learn something.
I'll go and get it.
No, learn something that's going to be useful, something you can use.
I don't know when you're going to realise what's going on, Mum, but this ain't Toy Town, you know. This is about survival of the fittest. Look at us. Look at the old man. If you think when I'm his age I want to end up like that, then you've got another thing coming. Work all your life so they can spit at you from a great height. Well, it ain't for me, Mum. It ain't going to happen to me.
Mark, it's all for you. Hello, Mum.
Hello, Jude.
Flo's that side.
Neil?
Yeah.
All right. See you later. Al.
What are
you going to be? I don't know.
What, you're going to be late?
I don't know.
I'll tell you what, if you're back in time, we'll go to the Vic...
Bye, son.
Mark?
Yeah?
You're not coming back, are you?
Bye, son. Hi, Mum.
Mark.
Back again like a bad penny.
Darling. Arthur, quick, it's Mark.
Come in, Mark.
Hello, son. How are you? Nice to see you. Give him a chance, Pauline. Give him a chance.
I want to know everything.
I'm living in Gloucester at the moment.
Gloucester? Why?
I've got mates there, that's all. Like, I'm not stopping. I've got to get my lift back first thing tomorrow.
What, tomorrow's so soon? Why can't you stay longer? Are you working? Is it a job?
Listen, dear, he's had a long journey. Give him a cup of tea and a bit of Christmas cake.
Or some Christmas dinner, eh? There's plenty, isn't there, Cap? Do you want some turkey?
A cup of tea would be fine. When I've had that, I'll tell you what I've been up to.
All right, then.
I tell you what, Mark. You've definitely got the right idea, mate. Just come to visit him once a year and then disappear.
Thanks, then you shouldn't have.
Not much. You know me. I'll always give something for the nippers.
Oh, look, that kid, another present, that brain. She's getting spoiled.
I want to it then, shall I? That's all she's got.
Hey, come here.
Look,
more? Yeah, more, yeah. Yeah, look. Look, here you go, look. See that? What you do? See that, what you do? You turn that round, right? The picture goes. Hey? Good, isn't it? Hey? How about the music? You like that? Oh, you want the wrapping paper? I've just spent a fortune on this and you want wrapping paper? That's it.